jack up your car and remove the wheels. Two 14mm bolts hold the caliper to the caliper bracket. Remove these bolts and the caliper will slide off. Have a hanger or jack stand ready to support the caliper. Do not let it hang by the brake line. You can now pull off the old pads. Apply grease to metal contact points for the new pads. I like to apply excessive grease and wipe away any extra after reassembly. If your pads come with new metal clips, replace these. If not, reuse what you have. Place a spring clip on the bottom side of the calipers and use a screwdriver if necessary to pull back the clips and slide the pad in place. Loosen the cap on the brake fluid reservoir prior to compressing the pistons. You can use a piston compressor tool to compress the pistons, but I am just using an old brake pad and a C-clamp. Fully compress the pistons and confirm they are flush, then clean and inspect the boots for any cracks. Do not make the mistake I did. Continually monitor your brake fluid reservoir to make sure you are not overflowing the reservoir when compressing the pistons. A designated brake fluid turkey baster can extract any excess fluid. Reinstall the calipers. Depending on the condition of your calipers, you may also want to grease any moving components and pins. Apply some red Loctite to the 14mm bolts. There is an 18mm inner nut that you can hold when tightening the bolts down. You can now wipe away any excess grease. The rears are the exact same process, just with a single piston to compress. Some pads may have these wear indicators which rub against the rotor and create a unique humming noise when it's time to replace the pads. I suggest placing these on the inside of the caliper with the piston, as I've experienced the inner pads wear a little bit faster than the outer pads. Once these are done, replace the reservoir cap. You can now bed the brakes. Because we fully press the pistons into the calipers, when you first start the car, be certain to depress the brake pedal fully a few times. That way you can pump the fluid back into the calipers and close up any gap that might be between the pad and the rotor. Now the process of bedding the brakes is actually quite simple. You want to get yourself up to about 20 miles an hour and then slam on the brakes. Now, we want to get ourselves up to about 30 miles an hour and then slam on the brakes. And now we're going to go to 40 miles an hour, so on and so forth. Do this until you get up to 60 miles an hour and then do probably 4 or 5 hard stops from 60 miles an hour. Always make certain that you're going in a straight line. Also make certain that there's nobody behind you. Of course, while you're driving along, you want to be listening for any squealing or strange noises, anything that sounds like it might be rubbing. Now, ideally, you would be bleeding the brakes after compressing the pistons. I plan to bleed the brakes in the near future, so that's why I did not do that right now. But in a perfect world, you don't want to be pushing dirty fluid back up into the brake fluid reservoir. Though, my fluid did look really clean, so that's a good thing. Now, it's also worth noting that I only replaced the pads. I did not replace the rotors. I measured the thickness of my rotors and they are still within the factory spec, so they're still safe to use. I've found that in most cases, I can usually get by with replacing the rotors every other pad change. So the next time I replace the pads, I'll also replace the rotors.